Our Voice of Africa is complete with a woman's voice expressed through visual communication and multimedia.
Once upon a time, there lived a woman called Arevahare, who had a daughter called Manzi. One Monday morning, Manzi woke up and wanted to go to school. The school was called Kaharo Primary School. Unfortunately, it had rained heavily and the roads had flooded, yet Arevahare wanted to take Manzi to school. So Arevahare had to find ways of transporting her daughter to school. She then decided to carry her on her shoulders because she never wanted her daughter to miss school for even a single day.
A group of elite women had visited the school to have a talk with the children. The talk was about social, economic, political issues and opportunities such as children's rights to education, health, etc., according to Article 34 of the Constitution of Uganda.
While returning from school, Manzi reflected on the talk she had at school and immediately made up her mind to study until she graduated.
Manzi studied hard and graduated with a Bachelor's of Law. This was because she wanted to understand laws that affect her as a woman. It is clear that women constitute over half of the world and the African populations. Uganda's population is 50.26% women and 49.74% men, according to the National Population Authority of 2015. Women provide the labor that sustains the continent's agricultural economy.
Yet, although through affirmative action programs, many women are enjoying better lives, the majority of women in the developing world still face challenges of access to information, reproductive and maternal health, and education, according to ACEN 2017. Female poverty affects many women in sub-Saharan Africa. As such, there is a need for a voice that represents this complex constituency of women.
In sum, Africa needs a collective voice to speak about exploitation, challenge marginalization, and resist oppression. However, if this voice is to service a common good and qualify as truly our voice of Africa, then its tone has to be modified to accommodate liberative voices of women.
Such advice would allow her to address the wider issues affecting Africans. She participates in the shaping of her nation state. She took a stand for not just her rights, but also for those of others.
In her poem, Our Voice, Nomia de Sousa speaks out, our voice of Africa, as that voice that is liberative, that voice which opens up new ways and lights up remorse, and burns glimmers of hope in the dark souls of desperate people who cry out for emancipation from slavery, that voice which creates new possibilities by awakening a cyclone of knowledge, that voice which can persistently and effectively represent the aspirations of millions of voices that shout, shout, and shout for freedom and self-actualization.